Good to
I'm
see you.
well, thank you.
And Maria, welcome back. Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Welcome. And Lydia. Hello, Lydia.
Hello, Alan. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. How are
Okay.
you?
I'm fine, thank you.
How was your day?
As usual, run-of-the-mill day.
All right. Nothing exciting.
Yeah.
Maria, how was your day?
I'm staying at home because I'm still a little bit sick.
Oh, you're feeling sick.
Yeah.
Okay. Hopefully, you can recover soon. We wish you a quick recovery.
I hope, thank you.
Yes. And Andre, how was your day?
Nothing special. We have not so good weather now in Kiev, and that is why the mood is not so good.
Yeah, over here it's been a very horrible day. I can agree with you. Probably, yeah, the same. Wet, very cloudy.
Very cloudy, yeah.
Oh, go
Yes.
to Moscow. In here, it was sunny day.
Really?
Yeah,
Oh, lucky you.
it's not so cold. It's normal weather, and I like this kind of weather.
Has this snow melted in Moscow, or is it still there?
Not so much, but the mood like a spring mood because birds are singing. I don't know why. Maybe because my house not so far from a river, river. I don't know.
They feel coming spring, maybe.
Maybe, maybe, yeah.
The spring is around the corner. Yeah, I think we are all anticipating spring, aren't we?
Absolutely.
Yeah, we had enough of the cold and the snow and the wet.
But Miracle said that she had awful weather yesterday. It was snow storm.
Really?
Yes, and she have to cancel her
Awesome.
lessons. Yes, because of connection, internet connection doesn't work, didn't work.
And where was that? Where was she? Where which city was she in?
United, I forget her forgot her place. How it's called? I don't remember.
Yeah, maybe it's
Northern States.
some of the northern states, yeah.
United said yes, but I don't remember the exactly city where they lives.
No problem. Hello, Artyom, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
How was your day?
Not so good because I ill.
Oh no, you're feeling sick as well.
Yes.
You're feeling like you have a flu?
No, I have, I think, a cold, maybe.
You have a cold. I see. Well, we wish you a quick recovery.
Thank
Maria is also suffering.
It's a virus in Russia, I think. And already two people died.
No. Really? Because of this virus?
I don't know how to tell it in English because of grip.
Influence.
Maybe influence, yeah.
Influenza, yeah, this is
Okay.
like a flu, a really severe flu. Oh.
In this case, I don't go out tomorrow.
Better stay inside then.
Yes.
Don't want to catch that flu. Yeah.
It's joke, of
Yes.
course.
Sorry? Yeah. Sometimes we have to go out and do what needs to be done. Yeah. Andre, how are your treatments going? Have you finished the treatments, or do you still have to?
Yes, I finished it in December, but the consequences, I have some until now, and maybe in future 3 or 4 months it will be full of I don't know how to say. I mean that some features of my disease will fixed until a half year.
Oh, it needs time.
Yes, yes. Because, for example, I have lost my hair. Not totally, but places on my head are empty, and I need to recover in this case. And some troubles with my throat I still have till now.
Yeah, so it does take time. So you're still going on regular appointments with just to make sure everything's fine, yeah?
Yeah. I need sometimes to control with a doctor. This last time I was one week ago, and they told me that I'm okay with disease, main disease, but with consequences I need to wait for recovering.
Yeah, I wish you a speedy recovery as well then. Mm-hmm. Oh, it takes time, but hopefully things will work out in the end. Yeah, that's a difficult process, difficult stage.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
It will be okay.
Yeah, hopefully. I mean, you've done really well. I'm happy you're able to attend the lessons, you know, and to, you know, pretty much continue what you used to do before. And you're still continuing with your tuitions of composing, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Yes.
Okay, so let us get started, shall we? We have the four of you, and maybe another student will join later on. So we are now on episode number 23. Yesterday we did episode 22. And as always, I will let you watch the video in peace. And after the 10-minute video, you can give me your summary. And then we'll get into the study notes and do some activities towards the end. So, as always, if you like, you can take some notes to help you with the summary later on. So, here we go. Let's get started.
Hello, I'm Margot Politis. Welcome to Study English IELTS Preparation. Today we're going to practice our pronunciation. We'll see how pronunciation can change when linking consonants, and then we'll practice pronouncing words beginning with H. Let's begin by taking a look at the story. It's about an area in Melbourne that used to be home to the growling grass frog.
This really would have been a fantastic biodiverse area. It's a situation where you've got the Yarra River outflow meeting the bay. You know, so you've got the freshwater ecosystem and the marine ecosystem coming together at that point.
These growling grass frogs were here in their millions, you know, hundreds of millions of them probably living in Melbourne. And they have disappeared very, very dramatically. Doing conservation with an animal that people recognise, and where they've had a personal experience of an animal disappearing, they really they understand the reality of what's happening around them and they want to help. And we can get lots of people to come along to a habitat like this and say, I want growling grass frogs back here for my kids and my grandkids, because when I come down, I want to be able to find some tadpoles to show them.
Spoken English can be quite different from written English. When you listen to someone speaking English, their words will often flow together. This is because native speakers will connect unstressed words with stressed words. Where these links occur, sentences might sound different to what you'd expect. Have a look at this sentence. He's gone out to dinner. We stress he's, gone, out, and dinner. The two is unstressed. When we link out, which is stressed, and to, which is unstressed, the final t sound in out is held slightly longer. He's gone out to dinner. The t sound is pronounced only once. He's gone out to dinner. Now let's listen to Jerry from the Amphibian Research Centre talking about the grass frog's habitat.
We can get lots of people to come along to a habitat like this and say, I want growling grass frogs back here for my kids and my grandkids, because when I come down, I want to be able to find some tadpoles to show them.
Jerry says, I want to. The final t sound in want is held slightly longer on the tongue. Then, to is pronounced. The t sound is pronounced only once. I want to. This type of linking is called consonant plus same consonant linking. Let's see what happens when a final consonant is linked with a consonant that's similar. Listen to how Jerry links the words around them.
Doing conservation with an animal that people recognise and where they've had a personal experience of an animal disappearing, they understand the reality of what's happening around them and they want to help.
Jerry says around them. The final d sound in around is similar in pronunciation to the first sound in the word them. This means the sounds are articulated very close to the same position in the mouth. When you articulate d, you can feel your tongue against your tooth ridge like this. D. And when you say the, your tongue is between your top and bottom teeth, like this. The. When you are linking words with similar sounds, the final consonant and the first consonant will be pronounced very close to each other in the mouth. This is the case with the final D and initial the sound in around them. This type of linking is called consonant and similar consonant linking. You'll notice that around is stressed, but them is unstressed. Jerry also uses the words show them. Here, show is stressed and them is unstressed, so we say show them. This is vowel and consonant linking. In this example, Jerry clearly pronounces the th in them. Listen again.
We can get lots of people to come along to a habitat like this and say, I want growling grass frogs back here for my kids and my grandkids, because when I come down, I want to be able to find some tadpoles to show them.
In spoken English, changes also occur when a word begins with the sound H, h. Let's listen to Neil Blake. He's talking about an area they'd like to return native animals and plants to. You'll hear Neil say, would have been fantastic. Listen to his pronunciation of would have. You won't be able to see Neil as he's talking, but it's good practice for the IELTS listening test. See how you go.
It really would have been a fantastic biodiverse area. It's a situation where you've got the Yarra River outflow meeting the bay.
Neil says would have. When unstressed words begin with the letter H, the H sound is often dropped in connected speech. Here's another example. I think he's in a meeting. The word think is stressed in this sentence, and he's is unstressed. When these words are linked, the H is dropped. In spoken English, we would say, I think he's in a meeting. Some common words that begin with the H sound and are weak forms include the pronouns he, her, him, and his. There's also these auxiliary verbs, have, had, and has. These pronouns and auxiliary verbs have both strong and weak forms. When they are unstressed, the H sound is dropped. But when stressed, the H sound is pronounced. Now let's listen to Jerry. When he says they have, does he pronounce the H?
These growling grass frogs were here in their millions, you know, hundreds of millions of them probably living in Melbourne, and they have disappeared very, very dramatically.
Because Jerry stressed the auxiliary verb have, the H sound is pronounced. He says, they have. So we've seen that when native speakers connect speech or link sounds in spoken English, changes occur. Being aware of these changes will help you in both the IELTS listening test and also in the speaking test. Let's practice the pronunciation we've talked about today. I'll show you a sentence and see if you can pronounce the highlighted words. Here's the first one. What did you send her? Send is the strong form and her is weak. Because her is not stressed, we drop the initial H sound. So it's pronounced sender. What did you send her? And finally, I told them not to be late. Told them. I told them not to be late. And that's all we have today. Let's review what we've learned about linking words. First, we talked about consonant and same consonant linking. The example we saw was want to. Then we looked at consonant and similar consonant linking, around them. And finally, we saw how the pronunciation of the initial H sound can change when we link words in spoken English. Don't forget to listen out for these changes when you talk with native speakers. And if you'd like some more pronunciation practice, you can find help on our Study English website. And I'll see you next time for more. Bye-bye.
Okay, now, let's hear your summaries. Maria, could you please give us your summary? Try to do it within 2 minutes, if you can, please.
Okay, so Margot told us about the pronunciation, that in the spoken English, the two words could be linked in one with another one in a quite strange way. For example, it could be connection between unstressed words with stress words. For example, he's gone out to dinner. Out is stress word, to is unstressed word, so we pronounce with as not as two words, but as one word. There are several types of constructions, then the pronunciation could change, the pronunciation of whole phrase could change as it would be before only two words. The first case is when they had consonant and the same consonant. So they had two same consonant together. Then it will be link one word with another word. The example is, for example, I want to. We have two T and we link with two T. The second type is when we have consonant and similar consonant linking. So a consonant could be not be the same, but when we try to pronounce them, we have our tongue in quite similar position. Example is around them. We have D, we have V sound, and then they link with two words, one with another, around them. And the third case, when we have vowel sound and consonant sound, and we cannot connect to this case, the example is show them. Finally, Margot told us that there are several words which usually are pronounced and which starts with H, and it's words like he, her, him, his, and all forms of verb have. And these words could have two forms: its strong form and its weak form. And when the pronunciation would be changed depending which word was before this this pronounce or the verb. If there is the stressed form, then we pronounce H. For example, in the expression they have, they pronounce H because it's stressed. But if H is unstressed form, we shouldn't pronounce it, and it's just dropped. For example, in the case, what did you send her? We could not pronounce the her as the whole word. We could say, what did you send her? Mm-hmm. And I think that's all.
Very good, I have to say. Really, really impressive. Yeah, you took a little bit more than than 2 minutes, but it was really well put together and well summarized. Thank you, Maria.
Thank you.
Okay, Lydia.
Now it's difficult to add something after this song.
No, I don't want you to add. I don't want you to add. Just put it in your own words, even if it's okay. If Maria said it really well.
In this video, it's very tricky topic for student who learning English because we have differences, different between pronouns and writing.
Yes.
And she point out us four main topic, maybe, yes, about linked words. She said the first is consonant plus same consonant. This how to say, they flow together, this last sound with initial sound in second word. And also she said about when they flow together, consonant with similar consonant, first with same consonant, the second similar consonant, the third she also said about H sound, it often dropped, and therefore the fourth was that she said about weak forms of H in pronouns he, him, his, and also auxiliary have, had, like that. We lost the first sound H, and this it flows with previous word. Mm-hmm. Yes. That's all.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Well summarized. On time as well. Thank you, Lydia. Okay. Artyom?
Yes, in this video we could figure out some advices for IELTS exam. For example, about pronunciation. When we pronounce words, we should understand which word is stressed and which word is unstressed. And the initial letter in unstressed word is usually not pronunciated. We also have it in some phrases like I give her. We shouldn't pronounce first letter in this case, so I understood. We have the same situation which when two words which when pronounced word has the same consonant like unpronounced word, and we also not pronounced the initial letter of non-pronounced word of non-stressed word. I don't know what to add. I think that's all.
Okay, very good. No problems. Thank you very much, Artyom. Yeah. Okay, thanks for your summary. Andre, lucky last.
As I see, it's not so easy to propose for you something more interesting that it's said before me, I guess, but I'll try to do that. As far as I understood this video, the main idea of the topic was a discussion about unstressed and stressed words and their connection in the spoken language. First of all, Margot told us about connection with words with two the same sounds, especially with weak sound like T. Two T usually should be pronounced like one. For example, in situation stressed words for, like want or ought with particle two, usually these words should be pronounced like ought to or want to, with accented first one and the short the second one. Very close situation when the when two words have similar sounds, but not the same, like T and D. Usually, such word with D sound may be accented and stressed, like around them. And in this situation, we should pronounce T, D, and the like one sound without a prolongation of the second one. Also, in the end of the video, she told about each sound, which can be pronounced in different way, depend on situation in which it used. For example, when both words are stressed, each sound clearly accented. They have, for example, in this situation. And in pronouns of the third person, he, her, and he, and other, H may be omitted are dropped. And in situation of use of the use auxiliary verbs have and H may be omitted too. That's all.
Very good. Excellent. Thank you very much, Andre. That was great.
Thank you.
Okay, so now let us get into the PDF right away because time always catches up to us. Here is the link for this PDF. This is the study notes PDF. It's got 6 pages. We won't get the time to go through all the pages, but we'll just go through some of the examples. So all your summaries were really, really well put together, I have to say, and I think the video was very understandable. Yeah. So let's just briefly go through these pronunciations and groups of pronunciations. So here below we have a table, and I'd like you to pronounce the groups of words in the following table and repeat one at a time across the rows, yeah, and then building up and adding consonants as you go. Make sure you pronounce consonant groups and clusters clearly and smoothly. Okay, so, and by the way, C stands for consonant and V stands for vowel. Okay, so let's start. Maybe Maria can do the first line or the first row.
Okay, it's short U sound.
Yeah, actually you said it before you even spoke, before you started. You said yeah, that's very good. Then?
Huh?
Yeah, you know when somebody doesn't understand something, say, huh?
Huh?
What did you say? Huh?
Us.
Yeah. Good.
Hot. Mm-hmm. Dub. Us.
Good.
Stub. Shuts. Tubs. Fast. And stubbed.
Excellent. Perfect. Yeah, your pronunciation was spot on. Yeah, very good. Okay, very good. Thank you. Lydia, what about the next one?
Mm-hmm. A, te, art, tet, stel, tots, starts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of them you said a little bit slightly differently.
Yes.
Yeah, so make sure this, the vowel, yeah, this R, it stays the same. So, R, ta, art, tart, star, tart.
It's not a short A, no?
No.
Okay. R, ta, art, tart, star, tart, start.
Very good. Yeah, that's much better. Thank you. Artyom?
Len. Glen, land, blend.
Very good. You had the easiest one so far.
Of course.
Yeah. So, Len, Glen, land, blend. Very good. Then, Andre?
It's a difficult sound. Were, burn, tone, loan, stir, stirs, slur, slurs, turns, loaned, stones. Slurps.
Very good. You perfected it, especially when you went halfway towards the end. Yep. This is a tricky one, especially when students look at the vowel letters. If you see here is an E, E, then all of a sudden we have an O, and then we have a U. But the sound is supposed to be the same. Then we have an I. Hold on. Yeah, so students who like to read how it's written, it's going to cause confusion. So make sure this sound is always there in each word. So you've done it well. So were, worm, turn, learn, stir, slur, turn, learnt, sterns and slurps. Yeah, very good. Okay, then the next one, Maria.
Okay, it's if, ill, still, will, still, swill, silks, wilt, stilts, quilts.
Very good. Perfect. Yeah. So this is the E. Ill, still, will, and so on. Okay, Lydia?
Me, be, she, eat, meet, meet, read, beam, shield, tree, meets, trees, beams, shield, streets, shields.
Very good. Yeah, so this is the E, the prolonged. Yeah? E sound. So E, me, be, she, eat. Excellent. So then we have quite a few more here. Okay, let's quickly do this, and then we'll start the activities. Artyom?
Oh. Go, out, pause, spa, spot, boats, spots.
Yeah, so this is like all, paw, ought, pause, spore, sports, and so on. Very good. Then, Andre?
Air. Air, where, chair, air it, where's, chairs.
Yeah, this one can be tricky as well. Yeah, so we have to say air, where, where. These actually are the same pronunciation, but different spelling. Chair, aired, where's, chairs. Yeah. Okay, good. Next line, Maria.
Ear, ear, near, nears, sneer, nears.
Good, yes. So ear, near, nears, sneer, nears. Excellent. And then the next one, Lydia.
I. Right, white, lie. I'm right, white, wine, lie. Climb. Rights, wines, limes, brides, climbs.
Very good. Yeah. I. Why? Very good. This one is easy. Now, this one here, Artyom.
Oh, this is the biggest one.
Yeah, it's the biggest. You had the smallest and the biggest.
A. Yes, A. Say, yes. Way, way, ray, age, aim, sane, wane, rain, rain, rake, rate, take, wake, lame, stain, train, bray, great, stick,
steak.
Way, stack.
Steak. Remember, it's always A, 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 A. So, great, steak.
Steak, okay. Steak, quake, blame, saints, wanes, rains, rains, rakes, rates, takes, wakes, lames, stains, trains, rakes, rates, stakes, quakes, blamed.
Very good. Only this word here is ache.
Ache.
Like you have a headache, backache.
Yeah, I have.
What about air? A, I mean this question, the second.
A?
Yes.
What? A?
Yes. The same like in Russian, A.
A.
It's like, it means kind of what?
Ah.
Yeah.
Oh.
A? Mm-hmm. Okay, what did you say? A? Mm-hmm. All right.
It's very useful.
Yeah, it is.
In chat.
Yeah, when you're chatting on, yeah, wherever you're chatting, what social media are you using? Okay, that was really good. Well done. So I've given you the link for this because there's still another 4 pages or so, and it goes into great detail about the linking sounds. So we have, you know, some examples here when there is a consonant plus a vowel. Yeah. Yes.
Small poem. PTK, PTK, Bekisman.
Yeah.
PTK is as fast as you can.
But try to say this fastly. Yeah, somebody's tongue twisters, yeah. Yeah, so you can practice them at home. Mm-hmm. Bake me a cake as fast as you can, and so on. Put it in the oven for Tommy and me. Yeah, so these are good ways to practice and to perfect your, this joining of the final of these consonants. Yeah, and if it's a consonant and vowel, and then we have consonant plus consonant. Yeah, or vowel plus vowel. Very interesting. Here, the silent Y. This is the silent Y sound. Yeah. Tommy and. The oven. We don't say the oven. We say the. Because the next word starts with a vowel. So the oven. If you say the oven, you'll notice there is a Y. Y. There's a Y sound. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like here. If you look at the phonics, the oven, Mia, I don't know, you can say, throw me a can, yeah? And then we have, if you keep going, the next side, linking the vowel plus a vowel. So it keeps going, and it's really, really informative, and I want you to have a look at these. So you have the link for that, and let me now start the activity, because we only have 5 minutes left. Are there any questions so far about any of this?
No?
All smooth? Lovely. Okay, so here, let's have a look at this first activity now. We'll get to practice the H, dropping the H, or the weak form of the H. So we have 10 sentences. On the left, the H is stressed. On the right, the same sentence, but you shouldn't stress the H. So this H is not pronounced. So let's practice this. Let's see if you can master that. First one, Maria.
Where did he go? And without H, where did he go?
Okay, good. But try to stress this more.
Where did he go?
Very good. Perfect. Here, where did he go? Where did he go? Yeah. Very good. Your pronunciation of this B question was very good. All right, Lydia, number two.
Where have you been? Where have you been?
Better. Yeah, you have to read it fast if you want to kind of.
Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Where. Are we pronounce R? Where are?
You can, yeah. Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Excellent. And here, where have you been?
Where have you been?
Excellent. Thank you. Artyom?
Tell him I love him. Tell him I love him.
Okay, this one was very well pronounced. What about this one again?
Tell him I love him.
Much better. Tell him I love him.
Tell him I love him.
It sounds funny, doesn't it?
Tell him I love him.
Well, especially when Artyom says it. Maybe he's saying it.
It's difficult to recognize in spoken.
Yes. Tell him I love him. See, this last bit especially. Love him. Love him. Tell him I love him. Okay, good. Four, Andre.
Call her to come to the table. Call her to come to the table.
Very good. Excellent. Tell her to come to the table. Tell her to come to the table. Mm-hmm. Very good. Five. Maria.
Was he there?
Very good. Was he there? Was he there? This becomes was he. Like,
It's like in French, vas-y, yes.
Yeah, I spelled like it. Was he there? Okay, very good. Six, Lydia.
Where has the boy gone? Where has the boy gone?
Again?
Where has the boy gone?
Good.
Where has the boy gone?
Excellent. Yeah, it's a bit tricky when you have this R here, yeah?
Yes, you should pronounce, yes?
You can, yeah. Where is the boy gone? Especially if you're preferring the American pronunciation more. Yeah.
It was difficult to say where is the boy gone?
Excellent. Seven, Artyom.
Why are his things here? Why are his things here? I don't know. I should tell it rapidly, yes?
Try to.
Why are his things here?
Eyes?
Why are his things here?
Eyes.
Aris. Actually, Aris. Why Aris things here?
Why
Aris?
Things here. I broke my tongue.
Things here. Yeah, it's tricky. It's tricky mastering this pronunciation. So this is going to be very beneficial for you to keep practicing. You must practice this.
Yeah.
And see this recording, this lesson that's been recorded now. You can look at this at any time. This is the benefit of it. So you can always come back to it and practice. Listen to yourself. Listen to me, and so on. Okay. Eight.
Give it to her, will you please? Give it to her, will you please?
Again, the last one?
Give it to her, will you please?
Okay, good. But this one's also tricky. So, give it to her, will you please? Give it to her, will you please?
Please pay him and ask him to leave. Please pay him and ask him to leave.
Okay, good. So actually here, we like above with tell him I love him, it's like here as well.
Mm-hmm.
Please pay him and ask him to leave. Please pay him and ask him to leave. Very good. 10? Lydia?
How have you been? And how have you been? How have you been?
Yeah. How have you been?
Oh, no.
The more we say it, the more silly we sound.
No one will understand you.
Not yet.
In the end, hold on, what did I just say? You don't even understand it anymore. Yeah. Okay.
Separately, every word.
Well, if you want to really perfect this age, the second activity is going to get you crazy. It's going to get you.
Really?
Look how many H's we have in these sentences.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So try to practice this. This will take a while. So I'll read it. I'll try to read it for you quickly, and then we'll leave you to it. So, Has Harold got half an hour? Henry needs help and hopes Henry needs help and hopes Harold can give him a hand, or give him a hand at the house. At the house, he will have to hand him 100 nails and a heap of hardwood, and then help him up the hill to fix the house. In Hartford, Hereford, and Hampshire, hurricanes hardly happen. How kind of you to help him.
And sometimes we pronounce H. Yeah?
Sometimes, you can't help but pronouncing it. But most of these are like here, help him, to help him. Yes,
because it's a has its weak position.
Yeah, excellent. Mm-hmm. All right, very good. So practice this, and the third activity here, you just have to choose A, B, or C to figure out what the connectives are, the linking phrases. Is it a consonant and vowel, or is it consonant-consonant, or vowel and vowel, and so on. And on the last page, you have the answer sheet, so that will help you. Okay. Any questions?
It will be better to have more exercise, I mean lessons with that exercise, because
definitely.
Everyone has problems with spoken English.
Maybe miracle will help you in this case.
But yeah. there are many students, and we have only 7 minutes if the class is full.
Wow.
Yes, so short time for practice.
Yeah, when it's a full class of a full full of students, you don't get much time to speak.
50 minutes for 6 students, it's so it's not enough.
True.
Okay, all right. Thank you.
You're most welcome. You're most welcome. I hope you have a good night. I might see you later on if you have.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay. Bye. Bye-bye.